This is a live lesson number 3. Life can be dramatic, but don't make it a drama. What did he say? I will tell you again. Life can be dramatic, but don't make it a drama. Oké, schelen. Geen tijd om te spelen. Next one. Live a life you love and love a life you live. Live a life you love a life you live and live a life you love a life you live. Do your song, it could never be wrong. Ooh, baby, what you gonna do? Ooh, baby. What you gonna do? I'm sick and tired of fooling around with you. Oh baby, what you gonna do? Ooh baby, what you gonna do? I'm sick and tired of fooling around with you. I wake up in the morning, fix something to eat. Before you go to bed, I even brush your teeth. Me come in the evening, you're still in bed with a big spliff in your hand. Oh baby, what you gonna do? I'm sick and tired of fooling around with you. Oké, schelen. Geen tijd te verspelen. In the meantime, in the between time, in tussentijd, altijd alles op zijn tijd.
My first memory of meeting him, it's not a special time, but he played other music. He played dancehall music, so Jamaican music. And we always go to parties there. He was an MC from Far West Crew. And the first time we met him, it was on... In his former apartment. So we were in the city, like drinking beers and things like that. And suddenly we were very near to his apartment, and he said, "Oh, maybe you come. I'll invite you, and you come to my place." So we went there, and he had also this. He had a lot of records, and he said, "Okay, which record would you like to hear?" I said, maybe Funkadelic and Maggot Brain. I thought, he never is going to have that song. And he went to his store with the records in, and he took three records out, and he said, which version would you like to hear? So, and I thought, okay, now we're talking. So that's the very first time I actually really met him.
I was very young, and I played a radio announcer in my room when I was 5-6 years. I make the top 100. I record with my hi-fi, with cassettes. I recorded the music, and there was the record collection of my father. It was, 2 meters high on the closet, and I need to take a chair as a youngster, and I climb the chair, and then I could take a record of my father like this, and I put it on. I take the record player and up, and then I try to, it was only a record collection. When I think about it, maybe 100 or 200 albums, but for me it was a complete another world. Yeah? My father, he loved crooners like Nat King Cole and Dean Martin and Frankie Lane and these guys. Frank Sinatra, of course, and I remember at one time when I start to grow up, I felt like, oh, this old music, and now I find myself being 44 already, still very young, but 44, and I love the music of my father. It's like this.
And I have a practical life lesson for all you guys and girls who take a shower in the bathtub. There are a lot of people who take showers in the bathtub. You put the mop in the hole while or during you take a shower, and then you can always take a bath for your feet. People don't think about it. They let the water run away down the drain. But please, people, put the mop in the hole. You can shower and you can have a foot bath. And it's less slippery. And for the eco dudes and girls, you can control the water. You can write down a little line with a pen to where the water comes, and the next time you break your record and you try to spoil less water.
People are afraid. Oh, I'm bored. They panic because, ooh, la 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 la, bored, bored. Please, bore yourself. Have a boring day. Wow, it's great. The best ideas come from a boring day. And it's also something I needed to learn because I live in this beautiful city and there's always something going on. There's always a party and there's always people calling, maybe. There's always one friend at a terrace who wants to drink a beer with you in the sun. There's always something. And that is the danger of living in the city. And then there's also the social media and the internet and everything. Boof, boof, boof. And then you feel bad when you stay in your sofa. You feel bad. And why? Why? I need to learn it sometimes through it. Sometimes I also feel like, oh, I've lost this day or something. This is not good. I did nothing with this day. But I can all, like, even in this house, there's always something to do. But sometimes you need to say, fuck it. You can always wash something. You can always iron something. You can always vacuum something. There's always something the supermarket you need. You can make lists. List people don't make lists. Maybe the only list maybe that's interesting is when you go to the supermarket, that you don't forget the garbage bags at the kassa. But the other lists, please. You can make a list of 100 pounds points, but you can very easily make a list of 1,000 or 2,000 things. And then I'm not even talking about the bucket lists. Ooh, why do people make bucket lists? It's like this welcome to the house of stress or something. Why do people make a bucket list? 50 years ago, the most important thing was you needed something with a roof. You need a partner, a good partner, and you need a good job. And then your life was perfect. But now you need to climb the Mount Everest, and you need to do the Iron Man in Hawaii, and you need to see the sunset in Japan, people couldn't fly airplanes for thousands of years, but when you don't fly in this life, whoa, you're a failure, man.
Gonna do, whoa, baby, what you gonna do?